Should she do me or?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, we got time.
All right.
I'm scared of dying.
What?
You want to do? Can you do something other than the palm reading,
sure.
or you want to do like a physical thing? What would you like to do with Josh? I mean, let's.
Do you have a question?
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Oh yeah.
And she said off air. She said
right side of your neck is definitely off.
Ooh.
Whoa.
We've been saying that, dude. It's jacked up.
What does that mean?
It means that skeletally, probably as you age, you're going to have a little trouble with that. Probably with the left hand, you'll probably have difficulty with that right hip a little bit.
What?
As you age, you may have more difficulty, you know, because you're nobody's in shape. I've never seen a perfect skeleton.
Okay.
Did you have your wisdom teeth out on your right bottom side?
I had them out somewhere. I don't remember if it was probably.
I bet it's the right bottom side.
I would keep an eye on that right bottom side. But again, I'm looking at you at 56, so I think you're okay.
50? God, so I'm
going to He's going to make it to 56? We never thought he would make it that long.
Is he making it to 56?
I can see him at 81. I can see him
Stop
at 82.
It. Yeah.
Until 82?
Yes.
No, you're not dead at 82. I can see you at 82.
Oh. How far do I make it?
Right now, you've got a shot somewhere between 84 and 87.
And how do I look?
In terms of
awful,
how...
Like
no,
physically?
No, you don't look physically awful, but you look like you're about at 74%.
And what about
He's
mentally?
He's going to be 74% at 82. Good for you, buddy.
Yeah.
Mentally, I'm just a mess, right?
No, you actually have a lot of psychic ability.
Oh.
You have a lot of that inner, you know, you come across almost like an Aries in ways because you've got that ability to see the next thing coming, but you don't expose it until you're sure of it. Almost like a sleuth. Aries has a way of being the scout of the zodiac, you know, the first one to find the Indians ahead or the, you know, to find the new route. You've got a love for that.
Yes, I do.
Wow.
Do you want to do my... I want to ask her about something.
We were talking off air and you brought up the term death doors.
Mm-hmm.
What does a death door mean? And can you maybe talk about that in relation to Josh? Is that how that works?
She's a scientist.
Yeah, I was just going to say, a death door is not just that last door you take when you physically finally die.
No, you said everybody has multiple death doors.
That was a little general. Not everyone does. Most people do though. Most
right.
people have that close call that gets them to the door, but they don't cross over. Then you have the people that are in the middle of the heart operation and they see themselves above the bed, you know. That's a death door. You know, that's kind of crossing over. There really are, like there, you know, our third grade and fourth grade and fifth grade here, there are gradations to stepping into what we call heaven. And there really are times when you can step back. You know, if you've had a near-death experience, maybe you drowned. Maybe you had such a close call. I've had four death doors. But one was on a highway where I knew I was gone. I knew the truck had hit me and everything. And I found myself on the side of the road, totally, you know, almost unconscious. So reality can be displaced. Your higher self can change anything.
Remember what she said when she was reading my palm about the turmoil? At age five?
Yeah.
Age five was when I almost drowned in that pool.
Oh, I didn't even know that.
You didn't know about that?
No.
You don't? Boy, that's a story. You don't know what was happening then?
What about, can we do that?
My dad might not
want
me to tell that story.
What about companionship? Can you speak on, is that a thing you can?
Sure. Ask me the question.
We would like to know. Josh has a dog, Farfel.
Uh-huh.
And he just had recently had a dog, Pumpernickel. She passed. He has a new dog, Farfel.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And he but in terms of human
Farfel
companions.
Farfel is at home.
Right.
But Farfel's the new dog.
Yes, but we're talking human.
Pumpernickel is at home.
What do you mean?
Where was Pumpernickel? Did you have Pumpernickel when he was three?
Yeah.
He's in the...
She.
She's... Sorry.
It's okay.
She is in the house that you were at when she was three. She's in those memories. She's curled up on a bed, but she's three.
Mm-hmm.
She's doing the life march that we do.
Right.
And she's not conscious yet. Not, you know, she's coming. She will come into that because, mm-hmm. you know, they have, none of us do. They're mammals like we do. But I can promise you, are there three steps up in your house anywhere? Just three?
Like the base of the steps before you make that
what
turn?
What about the base of your bathtub?
Three. That's two. Three, maybe on the deck.
All I can tell you is they keep showing her going up three steps.
Uh-huh.
And so you will see her. You'll hear
what?
Her. You will see her in the house.
What?
Awesome.
Oh, let me tell you how. Cool. All of a sudden, you'll be real tired, or you'll be laying in bed, and you'll think you're awake, but you're not.
Uh-huh.
And you'll hear her. You'll see her out of the side of your eye. The peripheral gives us the advantage of the intuitive or the higher self.
Yeah.
They have that same advantage we do when they cross.
Yeah.
But she's in the house she was in at three right now.
Wow.
We would love at some point,
I want to say this very kindly. You did have her extra time. She was supposed to go in May. They showed her at the end of May.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Damn.
I'm glad you had the extra right time.
Now. Giving me the feels.
Give me the tight chest. Give me the misty eyes right now.
I'm feeling feels right
now. We
got to
go. We're so late.
Dr. Gwen MacGregor, thank you so much.
Just quickly, can you just say, what about two-legged companions, a human companion, is Spiegel?
You're not dating the blonde?
I'm not dating any blonde, though.
What I'm not is happening?
Not, am I dating a blonde? No, I'm not dating a blonde.
Damn, Dr. MacGregor.
Wow.
You telling me he's got a companion? What are you telling me?
Maybe he has an interest in a blonde.
I'm 42.
43. Watch out.
Next year, baby.
What?
Next year's the year, brother.
Next year, Spiegel.
Oh,